happy Monday, happy Sunday, depending on where you might find yourself on this lovely, lovely world. My name is Amy. Joining me today is the incomparable Rexicon Jesse, and we are checking out Circus Electrique. Game is on this side, Amy. Game is on this side. Circus Electrique. today's stream is sponsored, so the game is available now. If you would like to check it out, check the link in the description below. And that's about it. That's all the formalities out of the way, so we can just dive in and have some fun. I hope everyone is doing well. Yes, Marty did a quest log on this, so you can also check that out over on the YouTube account. If you're in YouTube chat, I do know the link was dropped for that quest log a little bit earlier. I was just telling Jesse, I know absolutely nothing about this game, except I had flagged it ages ago when I was looking for newly released. And I went, wow, this looks awesome. I would like to check it out. And so, yeah, really, really glad that we are getting to take a look today. Please let me know how we're going for volume and such. I have to do a heavy French accent. I don't know if I can pull that off, honey money. Can you, Jesse?
You gotta. Oh, no. I could not. I was playing a vampire hunter game, like tabletop RPG, and my character had a French accent, and it was horrific the entire time, and it was so much fun. But it was terrible. I cannot do a French accent.
Let's just go the normal difficulty. I might regret this.
That's good. It's also fun because I don't even know what type of difficulty.
Yeah, I'm like, I don't know. I picked a difficulty.
Like, is it combat? Is it platforming? Is it puzzles? I don't know. I like going in surprise.
1899.
10 years is far too soon after what he did.
Hey, there was a fire.
Oh, no.
Yet here I am, reporting on the least important story for tomorrow's paper.
Also, is volume good for you all now?
The grand reopening.
Woogie woogie woogie.
He hasn't lost his charisma. If not.
I can do an American accent.
Can you? I'll be the judge of that.
Something bigger. The thing is, as Australians, we listen to a lot of American television, so just putting on an American accent isn't that difficult for us because we just change like that.
I've seen these two before.
Fair.
Who doesn't love a circusy tune?
What? Right?
Die, die. I don't like people telling me to die. That I'm not about.
Crook, Balthy, save my niece.
Uh-oh.
Oh, dang. So are they robot policemen?
Bring these bothersome bobbies to their knees.
Seems like it. Overcome your opponents in battle with skills. Each character can use one skill every turn. Okay. Ball throw.
So this looks... This is like Darkest Dungeon. Mm. Like combat.
Yes, that is what I've heard. It is... I was about to say D&D style, which... Very different. Very different game. But yes, Darkest Dungeon style.
Oh, thanks, Deebs. I'm glad you like my background.
It's very good background.
It's a default Discord. It's just I have junk behind me because I just had to put stuff in this room to try and make the sound not as bouncy. Yeah, because I need to put up like some actual foam and stuff.
Man, that's the thing I should do instead. There's just stuff in here. Stuff.
I don't have any stuff. Like we moved to a bigger place, so everything is out in the living room, and it's like
awkward,
I have nothing
isn't
in here.
It? And you're like, well, I don't know, this room's just gonna be empty, then it's fine.
Yeah. Oh, SVS Guru 2000 given £5 to say, what do Australians think of Australian icons in non-Australian eyes? Steve Irwin and Crocodile Dundee. Just curious.
I'll start with Crocodile Dundee. No one really loves that outside. Steve Irwin is a national treasure here. If you dare touch him, you will get fought. Like, yeah, Steve Irwin is very much beloved and treasured in and out of Australia.
Okay, so he's just as loved there, at least, as he is over here.
Yes, he is. Yeah. Crocodile Dundee, everyone's a bit like, eh. But that's not really what we're like. But,
yeah,
Steve Irwin is an absolute treasure that people, like, very, very beloved Australian icon.
With good reason. Yeah, I can't think of an American equivalent to Crocodile Dundee, but it would just be like, oh, you know, like, some, like, just one-off action movie star. Where it's like, eh, whatever. Yeah, it's fine. Chuck Norris. I feel like I would like Crocodile Dundee more than Chuck Norris, but... Alright, so I want to know about this America. Bill Nye! No, Bill Nye's way cooler than Crocodile Dundee. Jack Hanna is no Steve Irwin. That's very true. Jack Hanna. He's there. He plays with animals. Alright, so this... I want to know more about your American accent and what American accent it is. I want to hear it. What part of America do you think this accent is from?
As in your accent or mine?
No, yours. I mean, you can tell me what mine is from too.
I would say it's very generic. I did have to attempt a Midwestern accent for a show I did once.
Oh, I definitely want to hear that.
Thank you.
It's 6 a.m.
Do I have to wait till 6:30?
Yeah, 6:30. Remind me again in 20 minutes and we'll see.
20 minutes, okay.
The show was August Osage County. I played, who did I play? I played Jean, the daughter. I would give anything to do that show again at least twice in my lifetime, playing Barbara, the mother, and then, Violet, the grandmother, because that show is absolutely cooked, and I love it so much.
I see your mother's lion.
I'll turn mother's lion. Imagine, like, inheriting a lion.
Yes, and just as blind. No thanks to you. Now, if you'll excuse me.
What if you were also allergic to cats, though?
Then this would not go well, would it?
Ah, for your circus.
Dear God, no. I need to understand what the hell just happened here. That's the new story.
Oh, I like voice acting.
Yeah, they've got lovely voices.
Let's find Dr. Mabry. He hid once this maddening took hold, but...
That means we don't have to do the hell sign where we go back and forth doing bad accents.
Unlike certain present company.
I'll not have you speak of Grok in that way. Or growl.
Pacific Blue offers the sentence that you can say in an American accent. Of, oh golly, Jason, let's pop into the hamburger joint, and then we'll go to the mall and buy some Xbox. Which I really appreciate. The, like, disposition, like, of hamburger joint, which is, like, a 50s saying, and I think died off in the 50s, and then Xbox.
Oh, golly, Jason, let's pop into the hamburger joint, and then we'll go to the mall and buy some Xbox. I don't know what that was, but it was something.
That sounded like a, if South Carolina was in Australia, that's where that accent was.
It's just such a bizarre sentence. Like, you can't just put a normal sound with that. Like I can't even imagine how to say it in modern normal tone. But that was, it was very southern. It was very, I don't know if I can spoil it or not. The episode is out to public, though. It's like a character that was just introduced. Like Jack's.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Jack Southernville.
But it's a little less debonair. As
oh, she's got all the debonair when she talks, honey. Recruit a fire blower from the train. And her name's Bertha.
Yes, please.
I love her. I love her.
Whoever she is, love her already. Free fire named Bertha.
Yeah. Be right for us. Rawr.
Speakeasy thing, aren't lions usually antagonistic towards people they don't have a relationship with? I don't think inheriting a lion sounds great. Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, but it's her daughter. So if the daughter grew up with the lion, surely that, you know.
That might work. If they had a pre-established relationship, sure.
Oh, he brought a mime. What?
A mime.
Characters can regain devotion by performing in circus shows. I can't wait to find out what that mechanic is.
Yeah.
Higher devotion leads to higher damage and chance to hit. Okay.
Oh, okay. So external stuff to buff you in. Nice.
Very cool. Using
this mime has a set of robot arms.
Oh god, it does!
On top of normal arms.
Aw man, he played the trumpet! Now everyone's like, yeah, I'm feeling great now! Devotion may have two different values. The base value affects the temporary values and lasts a few rounds. So okay, I'm gonna kill him anyway.
Dang.
What? I missed? That's just upsetting. Oh my god, he tried to hit me with the slapstick.
Dang. He swung with two arms and still missed you.
Yeah, I know. Two sets of arms. The mime over there doesn't seem too devoted, right? So I can just, like, use fire.
He's just here for the paycheck. Like, whatever the equivalent of, like, a henchman temp agency is.
See, I would love games that have that weird bureaucratic nature. I would absolutely love to see more of that. And it's like, all right, the henchman agency. Like, what if One Punch Man game, but it was more skewed towards the, I can't even remember what it's called. Whatever, like, the league is that they are a part of?
I haven't seen or read One Punch Man, so I can't
help
you with that name. No, I've heard good things. But I have not partaken of it yet.
Get clapped.
Hey, you clapped him.
I like that so your character's not in combat.
Yeah, I was gonna say, what she is she just like, is she like Pokemon trainering them from the sidelines? Because that was
acting as their ringmaster, I guess.
Okay, because that's a thing in I reviewed a game called normal for you, ringmaster? Erratus or something like that. Is and you're a necromancer and you raise the dead and it's the same style combat thing, and like that was the thing that you as the necromancer were like right, but like you were basically watching them fight and you could cast spells on the enemies or buff your things and you were right there but you weren't in that line, and I'm curious if that's what they're going with this character too.
She's just giving them lots of like applause from the sidelines. Oh yes. Do it! Yaha!
Good job.
Good job!
Yeah, Erratus, Lord of the Dead. Thank you. Dead man walking.
Yeah, the Heroes Association, that's the one. And yeah, I'm with Deebs. Oh, okay. You would probably enjoy season one of One Punch Man. Yeah, season two wasn't as good. But I think it didn't help that Mob Psycho season two was so good. So I'm very excited for season 3 of Mob Psycho 100. I need to visit the sleeping cart. Okay. Oh, she's cool!
Oh, yeah! So lovely to see you. We stand buff, ladies.
Damn right we do. Perhaps the sleeping cart should be yours
for the evening. Also, what are those, like... like...
they're like shackle things?
Scuba gear shackles, yeah.
I'm curious to see what she kind of does. Because, I don't know, she's just kind of rocked up. Let Yvonne rest in the sleeping cart for the evening. I don't know who Yvonne is, but, like, I'm here for it. It takes time to heal. Let her rest in the sleeping cart until tomorrow. Help.
And here comes Dr. Mabry.
Help! 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 Save me from these relentless brigands!
More of these fop doodles?
Oh. Fop doodles!
Fop doodles!
I'm gonna start calling people that!
Oh my gosh, I love fop doodles.
What a silly fop doodle. Just imagine someone really angry in an argument with someone that's like, "Ah, you're just such a fop doodle!" Imagine how quickly that would disarm the situation. Because you just wouldn't know how to come back from that.
If you don't stop being a fop doodle right now, we're gonna have some words.
Although devotion can increase, devotion does not affect every skill. Skills affected by devotion are highlighted. Ah, okay. Okay, that makes sense.
Pacific Blue. No, I enjoyed Halo Community Night for the exact reason you didn't like it. I didn't have to shoot anybody. We were playing, like, basically mini-games in Halo. It was like there were some racing games where you'd get shot at and, like, obstacle courses. Yeah, it was great. There was very little shooting. I enjoyed. Lord Repa says, your intellect is as sharp as a fop doodle.
Good sir, I say your intellect is as sharp as a fop doodle.
I love it because there's no sharp letters in fop doodle.
No.
It's like, they're all round sounds. So that just makes it not being sharp even better. So can you add that other lady to the group?
I don't think I can. Days always end after battles with circuit results and character statuses reported from there. Okay.
Oh, apparently I
joined the circus.
I apparently sound loud sometimes. I'm going to turn myself down a little bit.
Oh, cool. Thank you.
Or you can turn me down, either one. Just let me know. But I can
If you do it on your end, that might be a little bit easier.
Well, let me lower myself. How's that? Because I have to crank myself to like 1,000.
You now sound a little bit quiet to me.
All right. How's that? Is that too quiet for everybody else? Let me turn
up a little bit more.
How's this? That's too much. All right. How about we'll go right here? How's
yeah,
this?
I feel like wherever this you are at the moment feels good, but.
Yeah.
But we'll see in a sec. Effects from buildings are realized the following day. Yvonne was healed after a night in the sleeping cart and decided to join. You want
my opinion on it? Right. Honey Money says that sounds good. Max says fine.
Exactly then. Everything around us went to hell.
Cool. There we go. Thanks for letting me know.
You should see what happened to the London Bridge. The London Bridge? Has it fallen down?
I knew that was coming.
Yeah, no. Terrible joke. Terrible pun. Would Darren Mooney like it? That's the real question.
I can give man.
To see for yourself. I just need time. All things come shortly. That's where
she'll the circus tent, so she'll be with me watching High Fly my shows.
You don't want to recruit more talent at the train first?
A marvelous suggestion, Amy. First the train,
I
then the circus.
Like that
just weirded me out.
What?
His said a marvelous suggestion, Amy. And I'm like, what? And it's because her name's Amelia, and he was shortening it to Amy, which brings me to a weird-ass point of my friend the other day at work was like, what's Amy short for? And I'm like, nothing, it's my name. He's like, no, it's not. And I'm like, it is. And I was like, Amelia's probably the only name I can think of where it is Amy can be a shortened form of Amelia. But that's like the only name I can think of. Anyway, that just really threw me because I was like, why is he talking to me?
They pulled a real Doki Doki Literature Club where it just looks at your name on Steam and then says it back to you.
Yeah, that's creepy. Okay, people are saying Amanda, and never once had I heard that till my friend Googled it as part of this conversation. And it's very weird because that's my mum's name, and I'm like, I am literally not named after my mum. Like,
maybe you secretly are. Shortened, abbreviated.
That's really weird that I had never heard that, and someone was like, Amanda, and I'm like, what? No. Like,
I honestly don't think I've heard Amy short for Amanda either. At least not in real life.
Clearly it's a thing. It's a thing. Smaller Amanda.
I like Amy short for Amethyst or Amaterasu. I like both of those.
See, I like Abdul's. Amy is shortened of amazing. I'm just chucking a wine.
Oh, that's pretty good. Honeymoney said, Amy, did you tell Jesse how you got your middle name?
I don't think I have. I told Marty, but my story's nowhere near as good as Marty's middle name story. I was like in tears when he told me that. Escape artist.
Wait, but what's your middle name and what's the story?
It's less about what my middle name is and more about why I have one. So I was just meant to be Amy Campbell Dunn. That was just meant to be my name.
Your surname is Dunn. Got it.
My surname is Dunn.
Amy Campbell Dunn.
And my mum got... She was like, okay, I'm going to go write her name on the certificate. Like, whatever they have to do at the time. Like, once the child is born, they have to go write the name down, register the name. She goes down, and there was another woman there, and she goes, so what's her name? She goes, like, Amy Campbell. She goes, but what's her full name? Like, where's her middle name? She was like, oh, she's not going to have one. And this woman just looks at her and goes, that's cruelty to your child. You can't do that. Like, you, what? And, like, my mum had just given birth, so she was a little bit frazzled and was like, oh, God, oh, no, I can't, like, put her off on a bad start already. So she just wrote down the first name that came to her head. It was Louise. It's, like, it's not the most impressive thing, but it was more just she was like, oh, no, panic. Write a name down.
Oh, Louise is a good name.
Yeah, it's a good name. Like, it's not a bad name, but...
That's... Wow. Child abuse?
Yeah, they're like, it's abuse. You can't do that to your child. And so my mum was like, panic! Panic!
Oh my gosh, that's freaking wild. I don't have an interesting story. I just have a middle name.
But do you know Marty's story?
No, I don't even know Marty's middle name.
Oh my god, I can't do it the same justice, but he has an older brother, and so at the time, the brother was like 3 or 4 or whatever, and his parents were like, we'll let you pick the middle name, and big Winnie the Pooh fan, so he was like, Pooh! And they're like, no, we can't make his middle name Pooh. And he was like, Winnie! And they're like, no. And he was like, okay, Christopher! And they're like, yeah, that'll do. So they let the child pick the middle name, and I just think that's the funniest thing ever, that he was like hell-bent on, like, I will have Winnie the Pooh if it kills me.
I was really expecting, after Pooh and Winnie, for him to go, the...
That's really funny. Kia Karashi says, I have an odd spelling of my name because my dad forgot how to spell it. You are not the only one. That is why my mum went down. Because it is so common. One of my friends has the exact same story. Like, it happens to so many people, is dad forgot how to spell the name. So funny.
That's pretty funny. Is this the, like, the get renowned area?
No, this is, I'm setting up my circus tent, but I want to get some chemistry going. So I just want to make sure I'm doing some cool stuff with it.
Is there chemistry between the characters, like, depending on how they interact with each other?
Yeah, it seems like it. Okay, so Von can kind of do anything. So that's my cool trumpet guy. So let's get...
Oh, I see. So there's the little symbols, and then that's depending on if they're the opening act, the main event, or the supporting act.
Yes. Oh, I'm locked for who cool I can put in for the first time. Green indicates strong relationship, red the opposite. Character's compatibility. Okay. The more stars, the more rewards. Okay.
Hell Knight says, just arrived. This looks like Darkest Dungeon clone. So the combat is, we're still pretty fresh into it. So it's only been like 30 minutes. So there's some other stuff that I'm curious about how it differs. I also haven't played Darkest Dungeon, so I know of it.
Yeah,
and I
haven't
know
either. You can distribute the stars you earned in your previous step to best your benefits from your next performance. Distribute your stars without exceeding the potential value of a draft in any category. Once you've distributed the stars, hit the announce button. The event will be held later today. The next day's newspaper will report the results. Huh.
Cool. Also, SVS Guru 2000 giving €5 and says, I feel like middle names are just for those occasions where your parents can call you by your full name when they are really cross with you. Yeah, they are primed for that.
A little bit angry, a little bit cranky.
Yeah, the full name comes out when you done really fucked up.
The event will take place after the next battle. Okay.
What a waste of time.
You love it.
Fireworks in the background.
Cool. Deep saying, I love Darkest Dungeon. This isn't quite grabbing me like that so far. I'm curious, what about Darkest Dungeon grabbed you? Because I'm curious, because, again, haven't played it, so. Other than I love the language in Darkest Dungeon. Like, I watched that trailer when it originally came out many times because I thought it sounded so pretty. It's just that really overly dramatic, like, Lovecraftian language.
Yeah. What I really like about this is the, like, the character designs and it being like a circus, but everything's that Victorian-y steampunk style, and I really like it.
Yeah. Also, why do we have middle names? Like...
That's a good question.
I mean, I'm okay with it, but, like, what was the point? Deep says the narrator and aesthetic.
Yeah, okay.
What pulled me into Darkest Dungeon. Yeah, those are really strong and very specific to what Darkest Dungeon is going for. That oppressive, like, existential horror. Which is pretty rad.
Yes! And that, boys and girls, is why he's so often the main event.
The slapstick where they just come in for a little cheeky slap is hilarious to me.
A cheeky slap sounds like you're slapping them, like, right on the cheek, though. Like, you're just like, psh, like you're aiming for the cheek.
Ah! Aha, and then it plays the trap. I am so smart.
Oh, so she's got... Is that a lock on the end of a chain?
Yeah, I think she's an escape artist.
Oh, that's freaking awesome. My gift to you all. Yeah, that's just a makeshift flail, and that's terrifying.
It's just a makeshift flail.
Flails are my favorite melee weapon. Oh, Deeps has to dredge it up. Dredge it up, Deeps. Enjoy.
Dredge it up. You got to dredge it up. Da, da, da.
There are some people.
Okay, someone's ready for a level up.
Ooh.
Ooh, you can distribute 10 points to increase their circus act values. Huh. Spend points. What happens if I auto assign? Nah, I don't want to. Amazement.
Ooh, amazing. Oh, you have a lot of points to spend. Is that for the whole team or just the character?
It's just for the one character.
Dang. You can really boost him.
Your skills to shorten your skills. I mean, front blow is pretty good. I'll just check that.
Michael Tepp says, okay, now I'm going to have to play Darkest Dungeon later.
Amelia.
Fair.
I have this for you. For answers.
I appreciate that you have an apex predator at your side.
No one
and,
questions
it. Has done that, and it has done nothing. Like, it's not a combatant. It's not like roaring to scare
it was
people.
Like a previous circus act? I don't know.
Just how dangerous are these?
Very. But you see.
But I like that it's there. But not eating people.
Yeah. I mean, it would be slightly more terrifying if it was, but then I'd be far too powerful.
Honey Mike says I like her skater dress. Yeah, it's pretty rad. I love those ape coats.
Oh, I know, they're gorgeous.
Yeah, they're so cool.
Yeah, like her character design, I just adore. I mean, all of the character designs I just think are really cool.
Yeah. Yeah, pretty neat.
And so we shall... well, let's... Does anyone want to sleep? Does anyone need a little sleep? No one really needs a sleep. It's fine. We don't need to sleep.
People need sleep.
No, they don't. They need to perform. They need to entertain, Jesse.
Oh, we really, as a species, we very much need sleep.
No, you're wrong. These circus performers need to sparkle and shine. No sleep. No sleep.
Help! From who?
Yeah, it is kind of like a shawl or a cloak, but it's like a specific kind. But I don't know the name of it.
You're offering safety.
So Blue says I only wear a cape coat when I want to appear villainous. It does help.
I guess I'm stuck with the four of you. But what order suits you best?
Oh, somebody your team.
Ooh.
From the available characters by clicking on the
dream. Okay, so you have several people we haven't seen yet, because we've got...
Yeah, Pablo, Maria, and Caesar. Pablo.
You see, oh, Caesar's not Balthazar, okay. So that was the same person for a moment.
No, so they're also... So Strongman, Fire, Clown, Escape Artist... Ah, they have slot preferences. That's interesting.
Okay, it's probably more moves in that slot. I haven't been paying attention to the moves they have.
Yeah, well, that makes sense. A bunch of who knows what. Spill under to reveal different types of events and items. Cool. And boss battles.
Woohoo!
Loot crate! Loot crate!
Wow, the inside of that chest was cushioned.
No need to yeah, I know. It's fancy. She fancy. Let's go this way.
So where are you trying to get to at the moment?
I see the map. Bridge.
Okay.
Just gonna make sure we put on a show tonight as well.
Well, you gotta put on a show.
Come on, come on.
Just for the ones that aren't with me. Now let's go do a combat.
Civic Blue says, I've been watching the stream for 38 minutes. I have no idea what's going on.
That's gone very fast.
Can we... How would you sum this up?
If you've played Darkest Dungeon or if you've seen Darkest Dungeon, it's that. Not that I've played much of it. There's definitely a lot of information it tries to front load you with, which can make it a little bit tricky to follow.
I like this galaxy inside of this clown's hammer. Whirling by.
It's an electrique.
Oh-ho! I get it now.
Big bonk.
What's Darkest Dungeon? It's a turn-based position strategy combat dungeon crawler.
Yeah.
It didn't make a genre, but it kind of did. And I don't know if it has a name. Because I've heard people say Darkest Dungeon clone. And like, or Darkest Dungeon like. But I have a hard rule with names of other games being the name of a genre. That's stupid.
Yeah, I agree.
Like, Slapstick is not called a Charlie Chaplin clone. We should not have the term roguelikes or soul-likes. What?
It's so weird when you put it in that context.
Yeah, right? Like, what if we called all novels, like, just what the first novel was called and then, like, or clone? Like, that's stupid. Or, like, all dramas or comedies. Like, it's a horrible naming convention. And I have no idea why games are so okay with it. Speakeasy asks, is it a roguelike like Darkest Dungeon? I don't know, is it?
It might be, but I don't know. We haven't gotten to that point yet.
I'm gonna see what it says on the Steam page.
Yeah, get ignited.
Tactical RPG. Strategy RPG. No, it is not listed as a roguelike. So if you like Darkest Dungeon but don't want a roguelike, might be a good one to go for. Stephen King likes. Yeah, that would be a horrific name. Stephen King likes.
Yes, my favorite type of book. Stephen King likes.
Yeah. And, like, that's why I like existential horror or extra-dimensional horror as opposed to Lovecraftian. Because I feel like it's a better encompassing of the genre than going to a particular name.
Yeah, Dark Souls is a genre now? Yeah, Souls-likes.
Yeah. Which again, stupid name. We should not accept it.
Yeah.
Should be a better name. Oh no, old Hunter disagrees with me. Says disagree with Jesse. Comparing to other games is the easiest way to convey the experience of gameplay, something that doesn't apply to movies or books. I 100% disagree with that point of view, because it is pretty much the same thing. Like, it'd be like, oh, it makes you laugh. You know,
something that we should avoid. And one of the big arguments for us not doing that, particularly in from a perspective of I am playing it and I am conveying to you what my game is. So this comes from both a game marketing perspective and a game like reporting perspective, is that say I've played Darkest Dungeon and I hated it, and you tell me this is a Darkest Dungeon like, I wouldn't touch it. Whereas there's enough elements here that make it different that then you are going to enjoy it even though you didn't. So it's kind of hard. It's kind of hard because it does serve a really useful purpose in very quickly getting someone to understand something, but it can also deter them from it at the same time.
Yeah. Because when, to your point, when you say, when you bring up a specific example, everybody is going to have, if they know what that is, which is what you want them to do, they're going to have a predetermined view of that. So when you say, it's like Dark Souls, and I think, oh, it's got rewarding combat and good storytelling, but you're like, no, it has a dodge button. It's like, oh, well, you're not wrong, but that didn't actually help me, and now I'm upset. Because I thought it was this thing, but it's not. So if the genre name has a better name as a whole, and then once you say that name, you then say, it's like this particular game in this particular ways or these ways. That works. But naming a genre after another game, I think, is just malpractice.
But yeah, it absolutely makes things very easy and clear, but there's also a lot of complications that do kind of arise from it, so it's pretty murky. It's pretty murky territory.
Yeah.
Oh my god, I just keep failing. You didn't like that. My devotion's like reasonably high.
Gotta be higher. Gotta be more devoted.
Yeah, clearly. My people don't love me. It's absolutely ridiculous. Alright, last bit. Oh good, she just left. She was like, haha, no.
She was not about to fight four people on her own who just beat up her two friends. Like, no, I'm good.
Oh, three friends. Took down three of them.
Yeah, that's a good time to split.
Ah, yes. Fine journalism, this.
Oh, this is kind of cool. So now it's going to show me how I did in the show. Grateful audiences. Surprise the company with the following gifts. That's cool.
Ooh, gifts.
It's giving me some lore here about like the mayhem that was unleashed.
Oh no, deadly riots.
It's telling me my circus balance.
I'm guessing like maintenance is the negative wrench.
Yeah, it must be.
Things like that. Old Hunter says, unrelated, Jesse, I just got done hearing your harrowing escape from the mushroom shop trip. Good job. Thank you. It was I'm glad you enjoyed that and that episode of Adventurous Nye. It was really fun.
It was rather harrowing.
It was very harrowing. I was like, oh, this took a horrific turn, and now I'm scared. It's weird that we don't record weekly right now, and I'm like, I wish we did. It's like, I want to get back to recording that show.
Yeah, I know. It makes me so sad when it's over. I'm like, oh. Now I have to wait. Like, I have to wait to watch it now, and that's even worse. Yeah, very sad. Wish we could do more. But we have to wait.
We gotta,
but I don't wanna.
D&D addiction is real. Oh, yeah. That's why tabletop RPGs are my favorite games. It's like, you play, you get in a good group, and you're like, this is my life now.
This is my life now.
Rapus, it's more time for Amy and Jesse to plan outfits for the nightclub things. Yeah. For our adventurous nightclub.
Night.
We can make predictions.
The greatest show in London.
Bit of a risk reward in that?
Okay. Show
really
is
like
ready.
I really like this art.
Your pardon?
I really like this. Like, this looks really cool. And I like the... name of that thing where everything's moving on different planes slightly.
Yes. Oh, that's cool. You can trial performers.
Ooh.
That's very cool. Arthur.
Glusa just realized the origin of rock between a rock and a hard place comes from Homer's Odyssey, does it?
Really?
I gotta ask about that for this on the Greek stream.
Okay, let's go explore. Damn it, I now don't have an escape artist. This is fine.
Oh, wait, why not? Because she's doing the show?
Because they're doing the show, yeah. That was my bad.
Okay, so if they're doing the show, they can't fight that round.
No.
Benzer asks...
a lot of fight performance. Yes?
Ooh. Benzer asks, are there... dress mechanics to nudge players to use varied team comps like Darkest Dungeon?
I think what they have is like not necessarily like a friendship mechanic, but more like down the street, standing atop a steam wheel. A composition, because they kind of need, because they're circus performers. I think there's something like that.
Ah, doodle flop.
What a word. What a phrase.
It's so good. Paul Sias, Casey and I are trying currently working on when we can do the Greek stream that works for both our schedules.
Always the trickiest part.
It really
part.
Is. And he has a real job. Man, that makes it tough.
That's why I get up at 5:30 in the morning to stream.
I'll ask that. I'll ask Casey if he wants to get up at 5:30 in the morning with me. Because we'll have a good audience at 5:30 Eastern, I'm sure.
All the Europeans and Australians would applaud you.
That's true. We could do it for them. There are quite a few here. I guess, you know, they stay up late, get up early for us. Maybe we should try it for them.
No.
Although I feel like I'd be more keen on staying up late than getting up early.
I wish, but it's almost too early for y'all if I'm up late. It's very upsetting.
Yeah. Oh, Hell Knight's European. There are dozens of us, yeah. There are, though.
There are dozens.
It's true. 5:30, we could get a whole new audience.
You never know. But a 6 a.m. start works well for me. And it's always funny, because when Jermaine's on, everyone's like, why isn't it a better time for Amy? And I'm like, no, you don't understand. Like, this is the better time for me.
Yeah. I don't think I could be entertaining to anybody at 5:30 in the morning.
Well, it's like when we record D&D, I'm really glad we started getting into a habit. Here's a little behind the scenes look. So we record at 6 a.m. my time when we record. And it's really useful because I love that when he strongmans them, they just yeet off the screen and don't come back. They don't die or anything, they just go.
That's funny.
Yeah, I'm glad we got into a habit of just talking beforehand. Because it allowed me to get enough of my energy and, like, interesting conversation going. So, I was always grateful for that.
Yeah, I really like that. I found that really useful in, like, doing that in, like, meet space games as well. Where, like, we all show up to play our RPG, and it's like, you gotta talk for, like, 30 minutes or so. And just, like, you know,
oh, God, yeah.
Warm up to each other. Like, even if you're all good friends, especially if you're all good friends, because then you want to talk.
Because then you want to talk.
Yeah. Little Lionhead says, why are the cops and mimes teaming up?
Isn't that what normally happens? The mimes?
I don't have a good answer for that.
Wow, today's performance resulted in total lack of gifts from the outraged audience. Wow, they hated that.
Wow, not a fan.
They didn't vibe what I was throwing down.
Amy, I don't know if this covers what you do in working out, but Pacific Blue says, Amy, I hurt my back at the gym. Any advice?
No, because that's well outside my scope of practice. The best thing I can say is remedial massage or go to a physio who is better placed to administer stuff for that. However, one thing I would recommend is core strength. Is a very, very good idea. And just doing some additional work on core training and hamstring and glutes are a good way to prevent further injury in such areas.
Solid advice.
There we go. Now that's a good show.
Ooh, oh, it's almost 3 stars.
Almost 3 stars. Very, very close.
Blue says, I was doing crunches on an exercise ball. That's what caused it.
Crunches are one of the least effective core exercises.
Really? What's it? What? what are the core exercises me as an aspiring six packer should be doing?
There's lots of cool standing strength stuff you can do. My circus is ready. Is there anyone that needs to heal? Oh, Grok needs to heal. Grok, my boy. And I still have enough to take us out. Okay, cool. Sorry, I just wanted to make sure I was good to go. There's lots. Plank-based things are always significantly better.
Ooh, planks. So, like, regular planks, and then what about, like, crunch planks, where you're down, and then you bring your knees up, and you're like, huh.
Yeah, those are all good.
Okay.
Any, like, of those hanging core exercises are also good.
Oh, that's good. I have a pull-up bar, so I can actually do those. Like, where you do, like, hang from the thing and bring your legs up to do crunches.
Mm.
Or bring your legs out, like, straight out.
Yep. Oh, God, cool. What is that guy? That guy has, like, a drone backpack thing?
Oh, he does. Does That's it have terrifying. A gun on it? I think it's gonna shoot you from the air.
That is...
But he's on fire.
Terrifying.
Oh, now you have two flame ladies. Nice.
Whistle mark. Now I'm depressed.
Oh, no.
Oh, what? He just, like, zapped
me. He does shoot.
Any, like, side oblique stuff's really good, too, because then you're working more of the sling. Anything where you're, like, hands and knees doing glute or, like, rotation, that's all really good, too.
Hands and glute rotation?
Yeah, where you're in, like a crawling position almost, so hands under shoulders, knees under hips. There's lots you can do with that, that'll, whilst not necessarily correlated, if you're doing stability, it'll then engage the sling down the back of the body. Yeah.
Good to know. All right, bump those crunches.
Yeah, like, they have a time and they have a place, but there's definitely more effective things you can be doing.
So what are crunches good for, then?
They're still a good exercise, but not as effective as other exercises. So if you're doing them in conjunction with other things because you've got a good core brace and things while you do it, then they're great. But if you're just kind of, if you're like, oh yeah, I'm going to work my abs, and all you're doing is crunches, it's not going to be anywhere near as effective. Crunches only target the top abdominals. They can't reach the middle or the lower core. So even like leg lowers, like where you just lie on your back down into the floor, and just like extend one leg, or if you've got a strong core, extending both out at the same time, that's going to do way more because it has to activate the top and it has to activate the bottom to extend the legs past the hip line. So there's just stuff like that which can really help. So if you're doing them in conjunction with other exercises, then it's going to work, but ultimately they only target a very small part of the core structure. Yeah. For context, for anyone that doesn't know, I'm not just throwing this advice around. I am a qualified personal trainer. I teach group fitness every week. Yeah, this isn't just random advice. I do have personal training qualifications. I do decide to qualify that is within my scope of practice to give generalized exercise advice.
Paul Sains saying, thanks for the helpful advice, Amy. And Garcia asking, any general health advice you can give? I already cut sugar.
See, I have none of that. I say, just do the type of exercise that makes you happy. That is literally the only thing that matters. That is all that matters.
You are more likely to do exercises if it is something you enjoy.
Yeah, don't think about what you should do, what you shouldn't do. Like, literally just do what is fun and enjoyable to you. That is my number one piece of advice. When it comes to food and that, my only advice is just eat what you want and eat what makes you happy. And if you have certain goals, do what feels right to you. If that is counting calories, do that. If that is cutting sugar, do that. If it's not that, don't do it. Don't do it because you think you have to. Oh yeah, we got gifts from the circus. They actually liked the show.
Woo. Yeah.
Oops, I clicked on the Discord by accident.
Whoop. Speaking of saying, if you don't like working out, you're not gonna stick with it. Yeah.
Yeah. It does help. We leveled up.
If it's like, if you like learning like a particular thing, I don't know, rock climbing, whatever it is. I like going to the gym sometimes because it's really helpful because I get to put on audiobooks.
Yes. Yeah. There she shines. The second pillar of power. Okay, so now the people out there are going to get more difficult now that I'm stronger. That's...
Ooh.
The more fame the circus gains, the more buildings and upgrades become available. No upgrades can be higher than the current level of the circus.
We get bigger. We get better.
Cool. Cool.
Great. Oh, Dave Dublanc gives $5 Canadian and says,
"Thank you."
Says, "I just joined chat. How difficult is it? I remember seeing this game when it was first announced. Completely forgot about it, to be honest. How is difficulty so far?"
Would say it's not been like absurdly difficult.
Which is good. It is the first hour.
It's definitely been manageable, but I'm now noticing I'm like, ooh, like my performances are getting a little bit rough. Oh, lol, I didn't realize it wanted me to upgrade the train to level 2. It's fine. I was able to upgrade the train. It's fine. And the good news is I bought more beds. I didn't realize I was buying more beds, but I did. So I actually can buy some extra performers.
Nice.
Which is useful.
Oh, that's what those slots are. Okay. Yeah, so it seems like so far it's really starting to open up with the, like, understanding the different mechanics and how they all work together.
Yeah.
The health, safety, and... enjoyment of your performers.
I don't know who I want to pick up. I've got 2 escape artists, 3 fire breathers. I don't love my 2 clowns. Well, that's not true. I really like one of my clowns. Don't love the other clown.
No room for 2 clowns in here.
I'm sorry, robot bear? Human cannonball? I haven't been able to find robot any bear. Of these yet.
Oh, I thought that was a performer bear. You could get.
I think it is. We just haven't unlocked any of them yet.
Oh, gotta get robot bear. Juka DeJetta saying, can we get an Amy do the Shia LaBeouf, but saying just do it.
Just do
or
it!
Or don't do it.
Just do it! Or don't do it. Just do what makes you happy. Jesus, he has high health. I'm taking this guy. Oh, he expensive, dog. Alright, let's do that show. He hates the clowns, so...
He hates the clowns?
Oh. He hates the clowns. I just want it to all go well, and I'm like, this is so stressful.
If you do 3 clowns, does it just become an ICP show?
Mm-hmm. See, now they everyone hated that.
Ooh. Everyone hated that. Garcia with another fitness question, which I've heard a thing about, but I want to hear your answer too. Says, if I'm one of those people who just can't bring myself to go to the gym, what advice could Amy give me? Gym is not for me, and it never will be.
Find what you enjoy. And that can look like a number of different things to everyone. It might just be doing brisk walks. It might be doing VR stuff. Like, there's heaps of really good things out there that you're going to be moving. You're going to be exercising. You're just not going to realize it. There's lots of really cool things you can do with that. So I'm just trying to put my party together for this, and then we'll put Yvonne there. There we go. Aha!
How am I?
Yeah, it's just about doing different stuff. I think there's lots of really good, kind of like at-home fitness ones, particularly after lockdown. I will always recommend Les Mills because that is the type of programs I teach. Or Hit Step. Any of the Hit Circuit company classes, because I'm actually looking at training in one of those
swimmingly
soon.
Thank you for sending them with me.
So I might even do some streams in the near future once I have my training for that one.
Ooh.
Mmm.
Yeah, that's fairly basically exactly what I was going to say, is do a physical thing that you enjoy. Like, I know people that, like, their main thing was, like, they did SCA, which is, you know, wearing armor and hitting each other with sticks.
Yeah.
Or, like, rock climbing. Like, they don't go to the gym, they just rock climb. Or, like, learning boxing or a martial art. Like, all those are very physical.
Yeah, performance of any kind. Like, anything that's absolutely movement.
Yeah, dancing is huge.
Yeah. I only started going to the gym because I had wrapped up dancing, and I was like, okay, well, need something.
Yeah, dancing requires so much from your body.
Contempt. Wow. Wow.
Also, do you have an arcade with a DDR machine?
No.
Also, you can.
But
that's,
if you do,
that's a good one. Do that. You know, just drop $10 a day on a DDR.
Mm-mm.
Oh, Speakeasy also saying DDR can be a workout. Yeah, it can.
Yeah, absolutely.
Sybil Simon giving $2 to the escapist over on YouTube and says, hi all. Hi all. Band Deebs. I don't have the Stan Deebs because that's in YouTube, not Twitch.
I don't have Stan Deebs.
That's my Twitch emote. I have an emote because Marty made the Band Deebs emote.
Yes.
So I made the Stan Deebs, which is the Deebs, and then it's got a pumping heart behind it. It's animated.
A pumping heart behind it?
Yeah, I that made it myself.
You went above and beyond. What can I say?
There we go. I put it in Twitch. Because we stand deeps.
We stand in this house.
I don't want to admit how long it took me to make it, though. It did.
No one needs to know. They can just be grateful for the final product. It's fine.
Exactly. You don't need to peek behind that particular curtain. Just know that I'm a professional and I did it, and that's all you need to know.
But yeah, the Escapist does fitness motivation videos is what I need. Look,
Just
tell Nick, make it what we need.
Make it a goal.
No, genuinely, I have been... When I realized that Hit Step can be streamed, I was like, oh, that's unusual. Don't have many, proper workout programs that you can teach online. So when I realized I could, I was like, I really, really want to do this training now. So, yeah, I'm I would like to do that, and I would experiment with some streams on my own channel. Just doing those on, like, the lunchtime, on the days where I don't, teach classes myself, at a physical gym. So that could be some fun if people want some movement in their day. With an instructor at the helm. Instructor being me.
You need one of those hype people working out in the background. I am on board for doing that.
It's me, I am the hype person.
But you're like the instructor. They got like that's like the ringleader, and then there's like 2 to 3 people behind them just like doing it not quite as well. But like trying to keep people motivated.
I wish I had that in my classes. I don't. It's just me.
Oh. If you do a stream, let me know. I'll be one of the not quite as good people in the background.
We'll just get your camera up in the background.
Mm-hmm. I'm on board with this.
These are for you.
Oh, dang, those are electric?
Yeah, no, electric cuffs. It's intense.
Dang.
Well, she didn't like that.
That's fair. I wouldn't either. If I took a barbell from a strong man to the face. Wow, you just incinerated that lady, and it said,
"Well, she fled." She was like, "Don't vibe this," and no. She just left. She just left.
And she went up in smoke and flame. The only place she left was this earth.
The only place she left was the earth. Lol. There we go. Pump it up, pump it up.
Nice.
There we go, we got heaps of stuff. Oh, where's poison? I love poison attacks. Give me poison.
Oh, yeah.
All right, how did the show do? Oh, it was like pathetic. Never... They hated it.
Oh, dang. Who was on that night?
It was Pablo, so Kate, and Eddie. People just really didn't vibe the double clown.
Dang. Too much clowning.
Too much clowning around.
Or not enough. They were like 2, but not 3. Get out of here. Wait, you gotta commit.
Yeah, clearly.
If you're gonna clown, you better 100% clown. Nobody wants a clown car with like 4 clowns coming out of it. That's not impressive. You gotta go big.
Gotta go big. Gotta go big, or you gotta go home.
That's true.
Oh, I can buy resources.
Oh. I love that it's just a raw steak. Like, here's food.
It's a raw steak. Yeah, I know. It's like, all right, you want food? Have some steak.
Yeah. You'll also have to purchase fire.
Every show has expectations. Yeah, I know. They've not loved some of my shows so far.
Yeah. Oh, you get an extra act.
Most drafts have slots. I quite like this little aspect of it, that it's like, okay, you need to put them into these shows, but then they need certain chemistry to pull it off. Assign a clown, mm-hmm, a strongman to double their stats. Oofed. Okay.
Yeah, I really like that mechanically as a thing for your characters to do outside of combat, but I also enjoy it narratively, where it's like you're making a show and it needs to be a good show and people have to like each other. And it's got to be like a proper order of escalation. Like, that's really cool.
Yeah. Except I'm putting my strongman in. Maybe I should put a clown in. I don't think I... No, I'm going to have to put the strongman in. Ugh! Okay, so they're loving, and then we need a blue on this side.
Old Hunters asked me, Jesse, what do you think of Magic the Gathering? Oh, ooh, that's a good show.
It's a good show. Oh, this, I was like, Magic the Gathering's not a TV show. What are you talking about?
No.
And I'm like, no, this, my performance is exceptional.
Your performance? Yeah, it is.
The performance is going to be incredible. These people are going to love this shit.
They're going to go absolutely buck wild over it. It's going to be great.
Oh, so I had like some spotlights or something that I could use? That's cool. Oh, so neat. It automatically gives me a star.
Ooh. Oh, so you can like really make it. What if you make it too good and then the next night people aren't as impressed because it's not as... You've already blown so many resources. Like, I wonder if that's a thing. I'm very curious.
Hold on to something. They're gonna love that. They're gonna love it. It's gonna be great.
I'm excited. Oh, but Old Hunter, what do you think of Magic the Gathering? Just curious. Jack was harshly critical on the R stream. I think there's plenty to be harshly critical about in Magic. I enjoy it. I have a bunch of Magic cards and I enjoy playing it, but I also am a completely filthy casual about it. Like, as soon as someone starts talking about real strategies, I'm out.
Like, yeah, I'm like, I like, yeah, cool.
Yeah. Like, there is a card that I was like, that's cool art. I guess it's going to go in my deck now. Like, and I'll make it work. Sure. Like, that's the kind of Magic player I am. And as that, I enjoy it. So, what it is on a competitive level is so outside of my realm of understanding that I can't really comment on it. I don't know if it's a good game in that realm or not. I don't know if Smash is a balanced fighter, but I think it's a fun game.
Yeah.
Because I'm a filthy casual. Have you played or, like, do you do Magic at all?
No, I am... I love Hearthstone. I play so much Battlegrounds, and I am reasonably good at it. But that's about the extent of it. Alex likes collecting cards, but he's never really gotten too much into the Magic side of things.
Mm. What does he collect?
Pokemon cards. He started doing comic books lately.
Oh. Not Yu-Gi-Oh?
Not Yu-Gi-Oh!
Alex, what are you doing?
Dragon Ball, but I'm like, those aren't cards. I don't know what I'm saying.
Yeah, there is a Dragon Ball Z TCG. Yeah.
That Disney TCG, goodbye my money.
Oh, I didn't even know there was one.
The Lorcana one, they've announced it, and like, there's no date for it yet, but my god, it looks good.
That sounds like something Disney would have already done.
You'd think, hey? Like, it is almost a little bit weird that this is only the first time it's kind of come up.
Or it did come up and it failed, and like, they have spent a lot of money to make us collectively forget about it. Collectively, get it? Like,
I heard what you... I got it. I got the goof.
Like, there, I'm sure somebody is an Imagineer trying to figure out how to wipe our memories of Disney Infinity.
Aww. It could have been worse.
I mean, I never played it. It could be great. I don't know. I just know it doesn't exist anymore.
Yeah, well, true. It's hard when generation changes happen and things, though.
Mm-hmm. Which, that's a... On that, that was a thing we... I saw that the Happy Meal toys are Pokemon cards.
Yes, and, like, they do that every now and then, yeah.
Yeah, it's impressive to me that that is still, like, talk about generational changes, that Pokemon, the card game, is still hot. Like, it is still going on. Yeah. Like, not only does it just still exist, it seems like it's still thriving.
It thrives, yeah. Not only does she exist, she thrives.
Yeah, like, I'm curious how that, like, what's the magic formula they think they've used to, like, jump that generation multiple times. It's on, like, three generations of kids and And two of them are adult now.
And two of them are adult now.
Conceptualization saying, hi y'all, late to the party. Is Amy enjoying the game? Amy, how are you enjoying the game? About an hour and 20 minutes in.
As someone that likes the idea of Darkest Dungeon, I know we were talking about, like, not using things before, like, not kind of alluding to this other games. As someone that liked liked the concept of Darkest Dungeon, but I went, oh man, this is just too hard. I'm just not patient enough for this. I feel like I am doing significantly better here. It's still challenging, but I do feel like I am able to succeed a lot more. So I'm personally having quite a good time with it. I quite like it. But I also really like the concept, because I just think it's such a unusual but really cool aesthetic and design of, like, hey, what if? What if?
Yeah, I really like the visuals that are happening here. Also, I think Casey and I constantly complain at each other, as in not like we complain at one another, but like we bounce off each other and hating it, is that that like paper doll style of graphics and animation.
Right.
And I understand, like, it's, you know, probably much easier to animate and that it, you know, it works, and that's fine. But like, I just don't find it visually appealing. And I really appreciate that these are, like, 3D characters.
Yes.
Like, it works for me. I think it's cool. And their 2D art assets look good, too.
How did my show do? Let's find out.
How'd the show do?
Success? Oh, we've seen better, but we still like it. I'll take it. That's what I think most people say about my streams. They're like, I've seen better, but I like it. I hope. I don't know. I'm amazed anyone shows up. I appreciate you all being here. Imagine giving gifts to like performers. Like these people have.
Does it say what they've given you?
Yeah, they gave me alcohol. Okay, look. They gave me some cloth, some herbs, and some oil. They gave me explosives.
Wow.
Oh, we have a level up, people. We have a level up.
Nice.
Oh, we gotta make those numbers go up.
Ooh.
Those are rookie numbers. We gotta bump those numbers up.
Old Hunter said, I recently played Contrast, which I guess has paper doll look, but man, I love that game. From what I've seen of Contrast looks really good. And if it does have that paper doll style, then it's probably one of the better ones I've seen. I would have to look at it again. Close. Get it. Explosive bottle. Guess.
Cool. I have items and stuff now. Where can I level people up? Oh, I just click on them. Level up. Level up.
God, you could upgrade. Make that flame hotter.
Oh, shit. Made that flame hot.
I really like the amazement icon. That face going, ooh.
Is that, ooh. What about amazement? That's really funny.
Monday Adams says, any stream with Amy is a winder. Winder.
Winner. It's a winder. I love being a winder.
I might say that because I'm transfemme and I really like seeing fab peeps gaming smiley face.
Thank you. I'm glad you enjoy. It means a lot. It really does. Like, I get up early for the streams I do on what are my Saturday and Monday, and it can be really tough sometimes, and I'm like, oh, like, I hope it's going to be all right. Like, I hope people still like me because I haven't been making as much content. I'm like, I hope I'm still, like, okay. So it really does mean a lot that people come out and support and hopefully have a bit of fun. I know I say it most weeks, but it actually does mean so much to me. So thank you so much.
I don't know if this. I don't know if this helps or worsens your opinion, but I stream like 4 times a week on my channel, and I still think that every time I go on, it's like, is anyone going to show up? Does anyone like me?
Yeah, does anyone like this?
Anyone want to be here? Also, hi again, Monday Adams. Good to see you again. Wraithbo saying, enjoy Amy streams. Did some real life puzzle stuff the other day. Oh!
Hey! Oh, I want to make a send in the clowns joke, but I'm like, don't do it, Amy. Don't do it.
Nope. Don't do it. Unless you got 3 clowns, can't send in the clowns.
Send in the clowns. Honestly, this show's probably going to be a little bit shit, but it's fine. They're going to love it. It's going to be great.
Look, they're not all winners, folks.
They're not all winners. Here you go. Some days, you just got to do what you got to do. Alright, Baltazar is healing. Is anyone else who's a bit more beaten up? No, we're probably alright. Alright, let's adventure in. Your available consumables can be found here. Oh, up to 6. Oh, okay, cool. Cool. Let's get Caesar up in here. And then, what do we have? Fire thing. Let's get Kate in. Yeah, this is good. This is fine. Oh, equip cola and a bandage. Oh, okay. Take a cola and bandage with you. Okay, I'm taking the cola and the thing. It's fine. And stares at the ground. He looks like he hasn't eaten in days. He repeatedly mumbles something none of us can make out, though we're relatively certain he's asking for money.
I hope we learned something here at least. Did you run into someone?
Yeah, I did, but I, oh, yeah, that ruined their morale. I knew I should have given him food, not money. Ugh.
See that goal number? We need to choose a performer whose enjoyment rating can best that sum after we spin the wheel. Then we can put all we've earned on the line to try again.
Old Hunter says, certainly Amy's energy convinced me to play Tinykins.
I need to go back and finish it. I absolutely adored that game, and I really want to 100% it. But I was writing a script over the weekend for a 3-minute review, which is weird because the last one I did was 2 years ago. It feels weird to have written one. Oh, it feels so strange. It feels so strange. Shit, I don't know. What am I doing? See the goal number. Yes. High enjoyment rating. Which one's enjoyment rating? I can't remember.
The smiley face, maybe? I don't know.
Yes.
Yeah, it says goal is the smiley face, so I bet that's it.
Yep.
Billy Will,
boy! I need to stop the wheel. Oh, God.
Oh, whoa. You better stop it.
We won. But do we
Yeah! There you go.
Okay, we only had to beat 2. I understand.
Billy Will, boy, saying, hey, folks. Yes, I consider Amy streams to be a winder, too. Good. They're all winders
bit
here.
They're long-winded, but they are. Okay, now we've got an interview.
Good news for you, Uncle.
Oh.
My editor is dead. Killed by the entertainment reviewer.
Killed by the entertainment reviewer. I am mortified that doesn't happen more often.
Ivan did that. How terrible.
Yes. And hug him if you see him at the
I have a, just now, a question from the audience after this dialogue.
Yes. My
single story. Oh, but I want to hear his dialogues. I don't want to talk over the dialogue. Oh, you have some choices.
In 1869, you sought Peter.
Yeah, we can interview him. That's kind of cool.
I don't think Barnum ever expected me to hold him to his promise of a favor. 3 years later, I most certainly did.
I left England for the took about 2 months, and all but two of my dollars. He was so amused that I went so far to take him up on his offer. He offered me a job to help out his protege, assistant to his assistant. It was all...
How did you get your foot in the door running a circus?
You know, I know your story, but I could use some quotes.
How
so
do you do that?
How flat. I suppose the beginning was in
1866. So first of all, you need to be born in like 1844, and then you're fine.
Dang it!
we failed already. We failed before we began.
Man.
He came along. The Prince of Humbugs himself. By chance, our paths crossed as Barnum explored the city. All he laughed and said he could use a good tour guide. Before we parted, he said to look him up if ever I was in America.
And tell me about working for his protege.
Oh, always something to prove with Eli Edwards.
Yeah, okay, so this is where, like, Barnum's protege then became the owner of a powerful corporation.
Asking for my help, I think Eli started feeling jealous. Didn't help that Barnum actually started referring to me, not Eli, as his protege.
And how do you feel about what Eli has become? Working for P.T. Barnum in his prime. And he actually preferred you to Eli Edwards as his top protege?
Rather unbelievable, considering Eli is centrally...
I'll let you answer your own question right now, Uncle Randy. I've heard about all
me too. Harder for me.
That's kind of cool that you get those little lore tidbits in between, like, battles and stuff. That's pretty cool.
That is neat. I like that. Judah Kajeta saying, how many words can you fit into a 3-minute review? Do you ever increase your tempo or speech in the editor to get more information into a 3-minute review?
Yes.
What is your word count generally for yours?
The one I just wrote was, I think, 550.
Okay.
I try and sit between 500 and 600. See, the problem is, there are some games you can go faster and it works perfectly fine. A lot of the games I review feel like they need to have a slower pace. And that can really screw me over, because I will be talking about a game that looks really pleasant and fun. But if I'm talking at this tempo, then it doesn't quite match the feel and the vibe of the music that's behind it. So it can be really awkward, but sometimes if you're running too far over, then you have to shrink it down a little bit so it doesn't distort it. Oh man, it's I have done everything. I've done everything.
There's not just caffeine in that American.
I've done it all. How long are yours?
If 3 minutes is about, depending on tempo, like 490 to 500 words.
Yeah.
So like mine generally fall like between 510 and 530 in the word count.
Wow, you're like very specific, like getting in that zone, eh?
Yeah, and I've tried to stop increasing my tempo because I used to do that. And then I was like, I feel like it's a better viewing experience if I just talk normally and not try and cram 600 words into 3 minutes.
Yeah, I definitely try to avoid 600. Some are hard to do. Like, sometimes if the game has a lot of things that you need to kind of explain,
oh my gosh,
it can be really, really hard.
Oh my gosh. It's, yeah, that's so tough. And then people will be like, oh, well, why didn't you bring up this? And it's like, well, because you know what?
3 minutes.
Yeah, I had 3 minutes and that didn't make or break it. Like,
yes,
I talked about everything I thought literally shaped my opinion in the most important ways of the game. No, I didn't talk about the crafting system or whatever the game had, because it didn't matter to me. Like, it did not make me like it or hate it anymore. It was just something that was there, and it wasn't worth the word count. I'm also curious, do you like tailor your words? Because this might be like coming from a fiction background, but I try and do like where I'm like, I only have 500 words. I have to make every word count, and I will try to choose words that have more than one meaning, or that
can
like
kind of get the whole thing across. Absolutely.
Oh, okay, good. I'm glad I'm not the only one that does that. It's like trying to pick those like perfect morsels of a word. Like, yes, this is encompassing the feeling I got from the game. And maybe if I choose this word, then even though I'm only using 10 words in this sentence, it will have the impact of a full paragraph.
Oh, 100%.
Oh. Amy, I appreciate you. You're great.
It's not you.
I'm glad this is... I'm not the only one. That makes me feel better.
Shit, I was meant to heal him. It's fine. I made someone else taunt, so he can't get hit. I'd succeeded. But yeah, no, it was very weird. Like, I messaged... For the audience, I messaged Casey and Jesse, and I was like, fam, it's been 2 years. I do not remember how to be concise. I ended up putting it together. I'm quite happy with how it's come out. But my God, if it's not a different experience trying to do that and get all the information across, like, people really do not understand how challenging that is. It's so hard.
Yeah, it really is. Another thing that'll happen sometimes is, like, where the person editing it will leave a note and be like, hey, you didn't mention this aspect of the game.
Yes.
And it's like, oh boy. All right, how many words can I shave off to get
that sentence 15
words? Yeah, to say 15 words about this part of the game. Or if you gotta be like, hey, yeah, that does exist, but I honestly don't think it's worth talking about. And that's like, well, why not? Like, oh shoot, now I have to talk about why it's not worth talking about, which means I have to talk about it, and then bring up why it's not worth it, and then that's even more words.
I've only that's ever had worst. That happen like once or twice when someone was like, this one particular aspect is like all over the way they describe the game. You need to talk about it. And I'm like, but like, it didn't matter. And then I'm like, yeah, okay, reasonable, like, I'll fix it, blah, blah, blah.
Oh, and the open party.
Ayo!
Wait, where did it go? There it is, open party rating. With a party. Hey, open party. Hey,
thank
everybody
so
coming
much.
In.
Welcome, welcome.
Welcome to this game. And us talking about 3MR scripts. Hey, Casey. How are you doing? How was Smash?
Pull up a chair.
Yeah. Did you play with items on this time?
Me?
You didn't, I know. How sweaty was Smash today? Ask
yeah,
Steve.
That's the question we all need to know.
It was sweaty. It had to have been sweaty. Casey says it was smashing. Nice.
Ah, ha, 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 ha.
Smashing.
All right,
oh, I just noticed the green bar and the blue bar are two different levels of entertainment for your show.
Yes. Yes.
But I don't know what they are. What are they? What's the green one? What's the blue one?
In the circus. I can't check now. I can't check.
Oh, okay. We'll find out.
We'll see if we can get there
tomorrow. King Dead 42. Hey, King Dead. Good to see you.
Hey,
gives $5 to the escapist and says 3MR always reminds me of my favorite quote. If I had more time, I would have written a shorter letter. It is. That's very accurate. It takes a lot of time to write something short.
I actually, so this was quite interesting. I wrote my latest one.
Yeah.
Like she's asleep. Where is she? Why is she asleep?
She's asleep with her eyes open. That's why it doesn't look like she's asleep.
I wrote the latest one. I went to a ball on the weekend and I had some time in between appointments and I went, you know what? I'm gonna use this time. I'm gonna make this work. And I ended up writing it in the space of about an hour and a half, and then maybe spending half an hour yesterday just tightening it up, and just putting things in an actual order, and I was so proud of myself.
Nice. Because
it was one of the quickest ones I'd ever written. I was very proud of myself, and I'd been procrastinating it for so long, and I'm like, maybe that's the secret, I just can't be at home when I need to do this.
Sometimes that does help. I wrote a lot of the script for, my behind schedule on Jet Set Radio, like, outside of my house. Very nice. It's just sometimes that change of scenery really does help.
Yeah, because you can't focus on anything else but the thing you need to do.
Right. This is why I'm very excited there's a coffee shop by my house now.
That is always the best.
It also makes good coffee. Old Hunter saying, did Amy just say she went to a ball? What, yes. Like Cinderella? Or I'm finally going deaf. You went to a ball?
Yeah, kind of. Like, it's not a ball in the traditional sense that it's like, ah, yes, in the formality, dancing. Everyone must waltz now. Like, it was just a party kind of thing, but it's a very formal.
So, like, what was the attire? Was it like, oh, you gotta wear a fancy dress?
Oh, yeah, it was fancy. I was dressed fancy.
Oh, that sounds so fun.
It was a lot of fun.
Wait, so what kind of dancing was happening?
Drunk lady dancing. I was not.
Awesome.
But they were.
That sounds like a hoot. I want to go to a ball.
Yeah, it is. It is a lot of fun. You get to get all dressed up, and it's nice.
Yeah.
That's what I was hoping would happen. I wanted to make the guy that was in front just leave. So I just kept bringing down his devotion until he left.
Yeah, just break his spirit.
Oh, damn it, I just remembered I was meant to record a quest log script. Oops! Oops!
Right. Well.
I'll do it at lunch, maybe. I don't know.
Yeah, I actually have a 3MR script to write after this. That has to be in by today.
Oops. There's been many games coming out. Oh my god.
Yeah, it's like, I had a bunch of stuff to do. So it's like, well, I could get it done today.
Get yeeted.
Dang. See, like, that dude flew off the screen. That's
fled. It's beautiful.
The fire one literally gets incinerated.
Feels good, don't it?
Judica Jetta says, you mean you're both slacking on stream? No, it's not slacking if you're getting paid.
Yeah.
We're just doing a different job on stream.
I have so many jobs. I'm like Jermaine. Jermaine and I are very similar, and I think it's just really weird. Jermaine and I are very, very similar, and we both hoard jobs.
Like, as soon as you get one, you're like, I'm never letting it go, but I need another one.
But I need another one.
Monday Adams saying, I could definitely watch a playthrough of this. Nice.
Yeah, I wonder how many people are streaming it. I'm having a lot of fun with it. I think we're about to hit a boss battle, so I think this is where we'll really kind of test the limits of what is happening. All right, let's do this show. How do I do it last time?
But last time it was just okay. Yeah, it's like upper tier okay.
Just okay.
So this is a horror themed show?
Yeah, this one is apparently horror themed, yeah.
So who do you have that's spooky?
This is a good question. Oh no, he hates
clowns. I mean,
clowns.
Fire is kind of spooky.
She hates strong men. Do I have another?
Ooh, wow, that score went down. Oh, you took her away. Never mind. Oh, now we get to find out what the two bars are. Drama and... Oh, so left is chemistry, right is drama, it looks like. Though I'm not exactly sure what drama means.
Yes, chemistry, devotion. Devotion is,
Oh, okay.
How, like, will they get along, or whatever that one is.
Got it. Juke says all the clowns are spooky. I don't know why people find clowns so spooky.
Really depends on what they look like.
Don't forget to buy some popcorn.
It's like Dead by Daylight clown, like, sure. Yeah, I can see that. Yeah. I feel like most clowns, they're just, you know, it's clown. I don't know. I think horses are terrifying, so...
You think horses are terrifying?
Have you seen horses?
I have seen horses in my time.
They're horrifying creatures. They have a really weird face. It's like their faces are all weird. They got those big eyes that just look past your soul. And then they have like these absolutely like muscular necks leading to these just huge bodies that are so full of muscle and like big haunches. And then they have these little toothpick legs that they're just like stilt walking on. And then these little hooves at the bottom. Like, they don't make sense as a creature. And I don't like them. I mean, horses are fine, but, like, they're spooky. I don't like them.
Spooky! Spooky!
They make weird noises. I start to think that nothing is wrong with myself. They're really big. I don't find giraffes scary at all. I think giraffes are great. They're kind of goofy looking.
They are kind of goofy looking. Oh, the London Bridge has not disappeared.
And their kicks can kill you. Yeah, that too. Big and unpredictable. Yeah. That's also scary.
Is this Eli? Is this the mysterious?
Ooh.
I think it is. Oh, I liked the transition from the... No, it's Eugene.
Oh.
We're fighting a... So this is a boss fight. So we're on London Bridge. All out amaze them. And now there's an amaze meter. Effectively using your character's skill will fill up your team's amaze meter, unlocking powerful super skills. Oh. Successfully damaging and neutralizing an opponent with combined with devotion will gain increased amazement. However, damage on a devotion loss decrease access. Okay. Recharge it to use super skills. Sounds like a good plan to me.
Wait, this is what they're like, lanky horses with little horn things. Yeah, but that's what makes them better. They're lanky. Like, they're not... They kind of look like they're supposed to be goofy looking. They're not like half muscular, half lanky.
Drone strike me, you butt.
He's going up.
Such beauty rests on this one.
Juke, it's not that I fear horses. I respect them because they're horrifying monsters. Yeah, I've ridden horses before. I've worked at, like, summer camps where they had horses. Like, I've been around them. I don't like them.
I missing every hit?
Dang, they're just so good at dodging.
This is not good. Oh my god, he used glitter! Why can't I use glitter? I wanna use glitter!
You gotta
glitter.
Go get some. You gotta go buy some glitter. What about zebras? Zebras look more like real creatures and not nightmare monsters.
They look real.
Like, their calves are a little more muscular. And I like that they have their like main stand up. They're still kind of scary. But they're a little less scary than horses.
Just a little less.
Also, horses too shiny. Gonna put that out there. Like, zebras,
horses,
they're a good matte color.
Shiny?
They're too shiny. They shouldn't be that shiny. It's just like you see one and they freaking sparkle and it's like, get out of here. That's not how hair works. I don't like it. It's like they got a filter on them.
No, I am. That's not for you.
Juke says, what's the scariest wild animal you have ever stood in the presence of? I'm very curious what your answer is.
No.
The scariest wild animal? Ooh, I don't know. That's a hard question. Like, I guess snakes, maybe a big kangaroo.
Gotcha.
That's a really hard question to answer. What's your answer?
I'm gonna be honest. In the presence of, like, I've stood, you know, I've gone to the zoo, and it's like, you know, it's like, oh, there's a rhino, there's a bear, there's a tiger. Like, oh, those are scary creatures. But, like, you're in a controlled environment, so they're not as scary. And or like Komodo dragons, where it's like, those are just really cool looking.
Very cool looking.
I think in reality, without the, like, honestly, like, the biggest adrenaline pumping scary thing would be, and I used to catch snakes and stuff, so I'm not really scared of them.
You used to catch snakes and stuff. You can't do that here.
Yeah,
because that shit will kill you.
Yeah, that's very true. You do, to be fair, you do have to learn what snakes you can catch here as well. That's a very important step in catching snakes, is going, that's a garter snake, that's just a rat snake, that's a copperhead. Like, that's very important. If you're gonna grab a snake, you gotta know what it is first. And I probably wouldn't do that in Australia. That's fair. A stingray. Actually, I got stung by a stingray, but that wasn't... It was so quick, it wasn't scary. It just hurt really bad. But, like, the scariest was I was out in... I was out somewhere, and it was, like, a suburban area. It was not very wooded. And there was a deer standing in someone's lawn. And I was just taking a stroll down the road. And, like, it was eating in someone's front lawn, and I was just trying to walk by on the road, and it popped its head up and looked straight at me like I was trespassing on its turf, and it was about to just punch my face in. It looked at me with anger I have never seen in wildlife before. And, like, that, yeah, like, there was malice in that creature's eyes. And I was like, oh shoot, I gotta get out of here. This thing's about to freaking charge me. And it was just like one deer. It was just one doe.
A deer.
Like, so that was, yeah, it was just, yeah. Ray, a drop of golden sun.
Couldn't help myself.
I think that's the next slide. It's fair.
It is. Me, a name I call myself. Far. A long, long way to ride. Why is this
so yeah. Now? So that was probably the scariest. It was just... Because even when I've seen horses, they were also in controlled environments, even though I think those are scarier animals. But, like... Also, deer have really long necks. And that's weird. Like... They just don't look correct to me. It's real creepy. And I feel like kangaroos are just bipedal deer.
Kangaroo are, like, both beautiful and deeply terrifying.
Yeah. Oh, I also saw a coyote once. That was kind of creepy.
You saw a coyote once? That would scare me.
Yeah, it just ran by. And I was... It was two coyotes. And I was like, oh, shoot. If this thing tried to attack me, I don't have any natural defenses. It's like, I could, like, grab a trash can and, like, swing it at it, but that's about it. That's not really super effective. Yeah, coyotes... They can be scary too.
Oh, I forgot. I have items. Heal.
I'm glad there are people on board saying horses are scary. Also, Paul, I'm not afraid of deers. But that deer wanted to taste human blood. It wanted man flesh. Do they have mountain lions in the state? Yes, they do. We have those here. I mean, not where I am. I live in a city, but like those are in the U.S. Nick says you should watch the movie Antlers. Is that the one with the kid with antlers?
I don't think so. I'm about to lose.
Don't lose. Oh, dang, you're down to two people.
Oh, yeah.
Is it a deer about... is it a film about scary deer? Because I do want to watch them. I love horror films. Oh, it's produced by Guillermo del Toro? Really? Ooh. All right, now I want to watch it. Oh, that's Sweet Tooth. Okay. Not all hoofed animals, I'm afraid of. But again, I wouldn't say afraid.
Just a good chunk of them. Just a good chunk of them.
I respect them for the horrific monsters they are. And that they don't belong in our world, and I don't know how they got here.
I don't know.
I don't know.
Don't know what you are? What? Don't know how you got here?
Yeah. They were designed in someone's personal Silent Hill and then escaped. And now they've been here long enough that we assume they're normal.
Silent Hill and escaped. Alright. Kill me. Take me. I didn't bring my A game. I didn't think it would be this hard at the boss. Joke's on me. It was.
Dang. So we're going to end on a boss fight, but it's going to be losing a boss fight.
Yeah.
Dang, how many of this guy are there?
He keeps using something called mirror image, so he just made multiple copies of himself.
Oh, that's a
good
move.
Very upsetting. Very upsetting.
No, I can't believe it.
Have I ever heard of Aquilin? No, what's that?
Oh no! So because they died, I lost them. Hot shit.
No, you've got permadeath?
We've got permadeath.
Oh, shoot.
Well, the good news is Circus did well, so we had enough money to buy more.
Oh, good news, the performance went well, so we can pay more
also
performers.
Good news, I didn't necessarily put forward, like, my faves, so it worked in our favor. It really did in our favor. Look, I'll just recruit to fill up my parties.
Nice. I kind of like that there's permadeath. Now I understand why there's, like, pseudo-copies of different characters.
Yes, and then you kind of unlock more, I assume, like, once we get past the boss, I imagine there'd be more, which is pretty cool. Do we need another clown? Oh, that one's got healing, so yeah, I'll grab him. Let's refresh. Let's grab another fire person just for funsies.
F in the chats for them. Yep.
Yeah, man. Rip. Big rippy Rooney.
Big old rip.
But that was it. That went really quickly.
Yeah, it did. It seems cool.
I like it. Definitely one you can lose yourself in very, very quickly. Which is both good and bad. But yeah, that was a really good time. Definitely not as intense as something like Darkest Dungeon, but was still a really enjoyable kind of party management, turn-based combat style. There's lots to learn in it. It's quite deep. I think it's pretty neat. So that was Circus Electrique, and that's my thoughts on it. Remember, there is a quest log up from Marty about it, so please do go and check that one out. Do you have anything to plug, Jesse?
I do. You can check out Adventures Nigh with Amy and Casey and Yahtzee and Jack and myself. A new episode came out, and I just tweeted about it because Jack tweeted about it, and I retweeted
Jack tweeted
it.
About it.
I just retweeted it today. I wish he would tag me in those tweets so I could immediately retweet them because I forget every week. And then I stream on my channel, which is twitch.tv/RexconJesse, or over on YouTube, which is Jesse Galena on YouTube. And I'll be doing stuff tomorrow and Tuesday and Wednesday and Thursday because I stream a bunch on my channel.
God.
And
that's
I know.
All the days.
It's pretty much all the days. I stream all the days. And if you're now a patron of, or on Patreon with The Escapist, I also have a Patreon, and you could go over to my thing too if you want. You don't have to. It's your money, it's your life. You do whatever you want with it. All right, that's it. Oh, Twitter and stuff. It's the same handle. All right, I'm done now.
Thank you. So make sure you check out Adventure is Nigh. Obviously, the main quest, as we're now calling it, is on hiatus for a little while. So you'll just have to find out all the things that happen while you wait for side quests. Maybe rewatch it. Who knows? I don't know. I can't tell you how to live your life. There will be some more content coming out from me over the coming weeks. Everything just kind of got pushed back. So all of a sudden, there'll be like 5 things that drop from me in 1 week. It's going to be so weird. So that was great. Thank you so, so much, Jesse, for coming and joining me today. It's always fun getting to hang out with my friends. It's the best way for me to start my week. And I hope it was a lovely way to either start or finish yours as well. We'll be back, of course, next week for Newly Released. As a reminder, there won't be a whatever Nick and I do, the co-op stream. That won't be happening this week because I will be away. But I'll be back for game night the following day. All the other streams should be on and around. Go forth, have a wonderful, wonderful rest of your day, and we shall catch you for the next one. Goodbye!
Bye, everybody!